Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, and today I will do Matthew 7, in which it is ask, seek, and knock. I will start from there and explain to you the passage narrow gate and wide gate. So, the Christianity is for the living in spirit people, and not for the dead in letters. Dead in letters only know the book knowledge, while the gospel is hidden under the parables, so that you can't get it unless you ask. When you start asking question, then you become a seeker when you become twice born. And then when you are bound to serve God, then you knock and you will be entertained by God. So ask is for the once born people. If they want to get twice born, then they should start asking questions. But if they don't ask questions, just read the Bible, come home, and that's it. Whatever their priest tell them, they just take it for granted. So, the priest is working for Mammon, money, not for God. So, where you end up, well, you know it very well. That means, in this dark age, everyone has to give his own account to God. So, your priest can't give your account to God. So if your priest is a blind guide, he will lead you into the pit. And this I will explain in the parable of the wide gate. So ask and it shall be given you. Seek and ye shall find. Seeker you become once you become twice born. Find knock, it shall be opened unto you. You knock when you are sealed to serve God, and then you knock. Knock is here, knock is taking the Eucharist to serve God only. But Eucharist is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit. It is highly mocked by these dog-collar priests. You don't take a baptism of John the Baptist in water. Only take once or twice in the lifetime. This Eucharist, every week, sometime every day you take it, you know. And the priest tell you it is in his remembrance. It is not in remembrance. It is entering into the bridal chamber to be married to the Son, Christ Jesus. That means your marriage is not good, you know, that you keep on taking one after the other. So it's a mockery of Christ Jesus, whereas the first baptism of John the Baptist in water, water represents Adam. In Adam is Abraham. So the first baptism of John the Baptist was in the name of Abraham, to establish their covenant with Abraham, because when they become Jew of physical body, then their covenant with Abraham is broken, because Abraham was not a Jew. He was a Semitic race, a Semite. So it's only in a tribal link, you know, that you can have covenant with Abraham. So John the Baptist baptized in the name of Abraham, handed them over, the sons of Abraham, to Christ Jesus to be turned into sons of God. So that is called the paving the way. For everyone that asketh, receiveth, and he that seeketh, findeth. So you keep on seeking and you will find it. And to him that knocketh, it shall be open. That means our Father will open the treasury of gospel. You knock at the door of our Father, he will open and give you the key to his treasury, as I have? Or what man is there of you, whom if his son ask bread, son, our God is our father, we are son, we inherit the royal kingdom of God, ask bread, this bread is not the one that you eat of flour, this bread is the gospel truth. Remember, Jesus said, unless you eat my flesh, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you are not part of me. So this bread is the flesh of Jesus, will be given. Will he give him a stone? That means, if Father you ask him, he will give you living bread, not the dead stone. Dead stone means the letters. Or if he ask a fish, will he give him a serpent? Fish is the one which born of the egg. And it is for eating. Serpent, it then, when you handle it, it try to bite you. So he won't give you something which is harmful, but one which you can fill your stomach with. If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children. If ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your Father which is in heaven give good things to them that ask him? Now we give our children gifts, you know. Even though the father may be evil, he will give children gifts. Then how much, you know, our Heavenly Father God will give us the gifts. He will shower us with his gifts, you know, which is gospel truth. Therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them. For this is the law and the prophets. So do treat other as you wish to be treated is the best law that you can have for peaceful living. Narrow gate. This is interesting. Enter ye in at the strait. Strait means very narrow gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction. And many there be which go in thereat. Now here Jesus is comparing the Old Covenant, in which the temple priest used to lead the people. And the rabbis and other people, they will be going behind the people and forcing them onto the wide road, because they do not know. They are once born, they are fed on milk, scripture, letters, dead letters. So as you can see, these are university professors, how they drive the, they take the skins of the letters without understanding the what those letters mean, or the gospel truths are hidden underneath. So these rabbis also are men of letters. So they teach letters to the children, which are scripture, is letters, written Torah. So when they have no spirit to explain the hidden meaning or the basis of those written moral laws, or give them the gospel to the grown-up, as the village rabbis, Samaritan village rabbis especially, they used to give that knowledge to the to their congregations. But the Jewish rabbis, they being greedy, and they had no way to give the gospel to the gospel to receive or to give. So they used to be hypocrite. They used to rob people of the money. Widows were robbed. All that, you know, they have no mercy in their heart, as shown in the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person. A rabbi passed by, a Pharisee passed by, no mercy on that wounded man. A Samaritan man came, he did not ask him who he is, just dressed his wound, put him on his donkey and took him to the inn. Philanthropy he did. That is the light of our Father. So that's why the Samaritans and the Gentiles, they did not need Christ Jesus. I have stressed this thing in my previous videos. Now this, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. That means twice born people, you know, you need to be twice born in order to find this narrow gate. The wide gate is open and you don't need to. Just these dark colored people and the rabbis and other people, they will push you into that one. No problem with them. They are the blind guides of the blind. So they fall into the pits of death or holocaust. But if you want life, and in this dark age, everyone has to give his own account to God, then you must seek the narrow gate. So this is by the grace of our Father, because this narrow gate leads you to the royal kingdom of God, which is the vineyard of our Father, where you get training in how to prune the vine, how to prune and all that, look after the true vine. So true vine is Christ Jesus planted in that vineyard. And people, when they enter into that one, they then copy, or they then seek the fruit from this true vine. So after tasting that fruit, that is mean the gospel, then they try to be perfect, or the same, you know, compatible with the true vine. So then they can get grafted to that true vine. If you are not compatible, then you cannot get grafted to this true vine and you wither away and you produce nothing, you know. So that is putting the light under the bushel. So people who enter into this vineyard, they must be prepared to preach gospel. To preaching gospel is putting light on lampstand, as I have done by making these t-shirts on, I put them on, and even though people may laugh at me because I look odd, you know, but I'm quite happy and proud to do so, because this is the way you can tell people that this man knows something. Ask him, you know, encourage people to ask them. But as the British people are, their nature is not to ask, just to look and just keep quiet. Even if an Englishman would not ask his next door neighbor who he is or where does he work. So like India, we know everybody in the street. This man comes from this man, this so and so. So here is different. It's a more to your own self, which is not encouraging to gospel. So people, when this is a wide gate, is the old covenant of the rabbis at the temple and priests, because they became blind, spiritually blind, so they became useless. They themselves were not entering into the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven is on this earth when there is law and order. But hypocrisy does not bring law and order. So they won't let anybody else enter. And these blind guide, when they lead the blind, they fall into the pit. Pits were the Holocaust. So this is the golden age for people who are living in spirit, who can ask a question. A dead man can't raise his hand. So letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So you need spirit to ask a question. Once you ask question, first you may be asking silly question. Slowly then you will modify them as you learn, and you ask sensible question, and then you become a seeker of his word, which is through logical reasoning, so which is called intuition. And when you have acquired this knowledge, then you knock at the door of our Father, and he will open his treasury for you to enjoy. Spend as much you like, and more is given to you. That is drinking the blood of Christ, preaching gospel. So this new covenant is to be propagated. But these churches, today I went to Mormon church, and over there met some young priest, the missionary they call them, and they said, oh, we were ordained by the church. Now the bishop, you know, their bishop ordains them. That means they were ordained of men. So they have to do what pleases those who ordained them. If they don't do it, their bishop will sack them, throw them away. But we, who are solitary, we are ordained by our Father. We don't need the ordination of the men. Our praises lie with our Father, and we glorify our Father when we preach gospel. And these Mormon churches people, they have written the Church of Jesus Christ of the Latter Day Saints. Now, Christ is the title. Jesus is the name. It should be Christ Jesus, not Jesus Christ. So that much knowledge those bishops have, or the church people have, what type of knowledge they can impart to the people they ordain or anything. So they are producing the wide road, and they are leading the people to sectarian riots. So first, if you want to go to the royal kingdom of our Father, you must seek the narrow gate that leads to salvation. Our Father, God bless